Let's go through four steps to evaluate a digital product's user experience by conducting a heuristic evaluation using Jacob Nielsen's 10 usability heuristics. If you aren't familiar with heuristic evaluations or this particular set of heuristics, you might want to pause and learn about those first. Watch Jacob explain what a heuristic evaluation is, or read about his set of 10 heuristics here. The first step is to decide who you'll conduct your heuristic evaluation with. It's fine to do a heuristic evaluation on your own if it's just for practice. But if you're truly looking to identify design problems, it's best to do that with a group of people. That's because a single person, no matter how experienced, is likely to miss some of the potential problems. Ideally, you'll want 3 to 5 people to each evaluate the design independently. Later, you'll share your evaluations with each other. Next, decide how you'll document your evaluation. You could capture your observations with just about anything, simple pen and paper, a spreadsheet, or a digital whiteboard tool like Miro. Alternatively, we've designed a simple free workbook to make heuristic evaluations as easy as possible. So feel free to use that as well. The next step is to evaluate independently. In this step, each team member conducts an independent evaluation of the interface on their own. Start the evaluation by moving through the interface as if you're a user trying to complete a task. If you aren't already familiar with this product, go through the task once just to learn the system without attempting to evaluate anything. So let's consider a simple clothing e-commerce site. I'll show a drawn representation of an e-commerce site, but try to imagine that it's a live, finished product. If I'm evaluating this design, here's how I might label my workbook. I'm assessing the mobile site, and I'm considering shoppers who are trying to complete the task of buying a shirt. So first, I'm going to walk through the process of finding a shirt to buy as if I'm shopping on the site. Once you feel comfortable with the product, go back through the task a second time. In the second pass, look for design elements, features, or decisions that violate one of the 10 heuristics. In other words, they don't achieve that goal or follow that guideline. If you're using our heuristic evaluation template, those will be the things that you write down in the appropriate issues section. For example, one of the 10 heuristics is aesthetic and minimalist design. That's number 8. This heuristic recommends that the visual design of interfaces should direct users' attention and help them achieve their goals. The product should not feel visually overwhelming or distracting. So, when I identify any problems related to this particular heuristic, I can note them in the issues section. This e-commerce site's listing pages layer the product details, like the name, price, and discount, directly on top of the product images. As a result, the page feels cluttered and the text is difficult to read. This is an example of how the visual design fails to support the user's task, choosing and buying a shirt. In the heuristic evaluation workbook, we might write something like, text overlaps with product images on listing pages in the issues column for heuristic number 8. If a recommendation for a fix comes to mind, you can note that in the second column under recommendations. For example, improve product detail visibility. Maybe add a solid or semi-opaque background behind the text. Finally, the last step is to consolidate the issues that you and your teammates identified. Once all of your team members have performed their independent evaluations, it's time to synthesize the issues. Affinity diagramming on a physical or virtual whiteboard can work well. This is all about aligning on which issues seem the most detrimental and problematic, and then deciding how you'll take steps to fix them. And that's it. These 4 steps might seem deceptively simple, but this can actually take some time before you get the hang of it. Don't worry, just keep practicing.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more of our UX videos, take a look at these over here and consider subscribing to our channel. On our website, nngroup.com, you can access our free library of over 2,000 articles. You can also register for one of our UX courses that offer live hands-on UX training.